हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर ए के शेख वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट एन बी नवले सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सोलापुर। आई हैव 12 ईयर्स ऑफ टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस एंड आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड माई एम बी मैकेनिकल इन डिज़ाइन इंजीनियरिंग। टूडेज टॉपिक इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑन डिफरेंशियल बैंड ब्रेक। सो दिस इज अवर प्रॉब्लम नंबर 7 फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर। लेट अस प्रोसीड विद द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम। In a winch, the rope supports a load W and is wound round a barrel 450 mm in diameter. A differential band break acts on a drum 800 mm diameter, which is keyed to the same shaft as the barrel. The two ends of the bands are attached to pins on opposite sides of the fulcrum of the brake lever and at distances of 25 mm and 100 mm from the fulcrum. The angle of lap of the brake band is 250 degrees and the coefficient of friction is 0.25. What is the maximum load W which can be supported by the brake when a force of 750 Newton is applied to the lever at a distance of 3000 millimeters from the fulcrum? So let us see the diagram. So there is a winch wound around this barrel. This barrel is 450 mm in diameter. The brake drum is 800 mm in diameter. This is the differential brake arrangement. The 750 Newton operating force is applied at a distance of 3000 mm from fulcrum O. OB is 25, OA is 100, and a load W is attached to this rope which is wound around the barrel. So we have been asked to calculate value of this W when there is clockwise and anti-clockwise rotation of the drum. So let us write down the given data. Diameter D, this capital diameter D we have taken for the barrel. Then the brake drum diameter 800 mm or radius 400 mm. Theta, that is angle of lap, 250 degrees converted to radians into 4.364 radians, mu 0.25, P operating force 750 newtons, OB 25, OA 100 mm, and L, that is length of the lever, is OC, that is 3000 mm, and we have to find load W which can be supported by the brake when the force of 750 newton is applied. So let us start with the solution. The first step, as we all know, the ratio of tensions T1 as to T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta in case of band breaks. So substituting values of theta and mu in the equation, we get this ratio as 2.98. that means T1 is equal to 2.98 times of T2. Now for the clockwise rotation of the drum taking moments about the fulcrum O. So if we analyze the diagram, so this is the clockwise rotation. This side will be, the right side will be in the tight side, that is T1, and then T2 will be on the other side. So this T1 is producing clockwise moment, 750 is also producing clockwise moment, whereas this T2 is producing anti-clockwise moment. So let us write down the moments. 750 multiplied by 3000, T1 multiplied by this 25, and T2 multiplied by 100. So we can substitute value of T1 as 2.98 T2 in this equation, so that we get only one unknown T2 and we can solve it. So rearranging the T2 terms, finally we get T2 as 88 into 10 raised to 3 newtons. By using this relation, we can find out T1 as 2.98 times of T2. We get it as 262 into 10 raised to 3 newtons. Now braking torque, T1 minus T2 multiplied by R. R is 400, we have taken it in millimeters. Therefore, this multiplication T1 minus T2 and R, it will go for 69.6 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm. So now the torque due to this load W. Now load W is subjected to this radius of the barrel. So torque due to this load W will be W into capital R. Now capital R is 225, So let it be 225 times of W in Newton mm. As this 225 is taken in mm, this will be in Newton mm. Now since the braking torque must be equal to the torque due to load W, we need to equate TW and TB. Hence 225 times of W, this value of TW should be equal to 69.6 into 10 raised to 6, that is our braking torque. And finally, after the calculations, we get W equal to 309 kilonewtons for the clockwise rotation of the drum. Similarly, we will be solving for the anticlockwise rotation of the drum, wherein T1 and T2 positions will be swapped. So for anticlockwise rotation of drum, taking moments about O, again referring the figure. Now T1 is on the other side and T2 is on the right side. So T1 will be the new tight side and T2 is the new slack side. So here 750 multiplied by 3000 plus T2 multiplied by 25 should be balanced by T1 multiplied by 100. So we have put it up here, and again instead of T1 we can substitute 2.98 T2. So when we substitute this 2.98 T2 here, we can take this to the other side and we can bring all the T2 terms on one side and numerical terms on the other side to find T2. So finally we get T2 as 8242 newtons. From that we can calculate T1 as 2.98 times of T2, as we have done in the previous case. Now let us find out the braking torque. Braking torque TB equal to T1 minus T2 multiplied by R. Substituting the value of T1 and T2 in this equation, we get value of TB equal to 6.53 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm. So now the torque due to load W, as we know, it is 225 into W Newton mm. Since the braking torque must be equal to the torque due to load W, we need to equate TW and TB. Now substituting the values of TW and TB, 225 times of W should be equal to 6.53 into 10 raised to 6. We get the final value of W equal to 29 kilonewtons for anti-clockwise rotation of the drum.